Madam, to expostulate what majesty should be, what duty is, why day is day, night is night, and time is time, are nothing but to waste night, day, and time. Therefore, since brevity is a soul of wit, and tediousness to limbs and outward flourishes, I will be brief. Your noble son is mad. Mad call I it, for to define true madness, what is it but to be nothing else but mad? But let that go.
More matter with less art.
Madam, I assure you, I use no art at all. That he is mad, tis true. Tis true, tis pity. And pity tis true. A foolish figure. But farewell it, for I will use no art. Thus remains that we found out the cause of this effect. Or rather say, the cause of this defect. For this effect effective comes by a cause. Thus it remains, and the remainder thus. I have a daughter. Have, while she is mine, who, in her duty and obedience mock, hath shown me this. Now gather and surmise. To the celestial and soul's idol, the most beautified Ophelia. That is an ill phrase. A vile phrase. Beautified is a vile phrase. But you shall hear thus. In her excellent white bosom.
Came this from Hamlet to her?
Good madam, stay a while. I'll be faithful. Doubt thou the stars are fire? Doubt thou the sun doth move? Doubt truth to be a liar? But never doubt I love. This my daughter hath shown me and more above.
But how hath she received his love?
What do you think of me?
As of a man faithful and honorable.
I would fain prove so. But what might you think when I had seen this hot love on the wing as I perceived it? I must tell you that it was before my daughter told me. What might you, my dear majesty, think if I had given my heart to winking, mute and dumb, or looked upon this love with idle sight? No! I went round to work, and to my young mistress I did bespeak. Lord Hamlet is a prince, out of thy star. This must not be. And then I precepts gave her that she should lock herself from his resort, admit no messengers, receive no tokens. Which done, for she followed the fruits of my advice, he repulsed, and thus fell into a sadness, thence to a watch, thence to a fast, thence to a lightness, thence to a weakness, and then by declension into the madness wherein he now raves, in all we mourn for.
It may be, very likely.
Hath there been a time, I'd fain know that, I had positively said, 'tis so, when it proved otherwise?
Not that I know of.
You take this from this, if this prove otherwise. And if circumstances lead me, I will find where truth is hid, as though it were hid indeed within the center.
How may we try it further?
You know, sometimes he walks 4 hours together here in the lobby.
So he does, indeed.
At such a time, I will loose my daughter to him. Let you and I be behind an arras, then. Mark the encounter. If he love her not, and be not from his reason therein fallen, let me be no assistant of state, but keep a farm and carters.
We will try it.
He will come straight. Look you, lay home to him. Tell him his pranks have been too broad to bear with, and that your majesty had stood in screen between much heat and him. Now I will silence me even here, and pray you, be round with him.
Mother!
I warrant you, fear me not.
Mother!
Withdraw! I hear him coming.
Oh, mother! Oh, now, mother, what's the matter?
Hamlet, thou hast thy father much offended.
Mother, thou hast thy father much offended.
Come, come, you answer with an idle tongue.
Go, go, you question with a wicked tongue.
Why, how now, Hamlet?
What's the matter?
Have you forgotten me?
No, by the rood, not so. You are the queen, your husband's brother's wife, and, I would it were not so, you are my mother.
Nay, then I'll set those to you who can speak.
Come, come and sit you down. You shall not budge. So I may set you up a glass where you may see the inmost part of you.
What would thou do? Thou wilt not murder me. Oh, help! Help!
Help! Help!
Help! Help!
Hello,
help!
Help! Rat. Dead for a ducky. Dead!
Oh, I'm slain!
I mean, what? What an act is this?
Nay, I know not. Is it the king?
What a rash and bloody deed is this?
A bloody deed? Almost as bad, good mother, has kill a king
as
and marry with his brother.
Has kill a king?
Aye, lady, 'twas my word. Wretched, rash, and true fool. Farewell. I took thee for thy better. Now take thy fortune. Find us to be busy as some danger. Oh, leave wringing of your hands, peace, and sit you down. Let me wring your heart, made of penetrable stuff. If damn custom have not brassed it so, it is proof and bulwark against sense.
What have I done that thou darest wag thy tongue in noise so rude against me?
Such an act that blurs the grace and blush of modesty, calls virtue hypocrite, takes off the rose from the fair forehead of an innocent love, and sets a blister there, makes marriage vows as false as dicer's oaths. Oh, such a deed that from the body of contraction plucks my very soul! Yea, the solidity and compound mast, a tristful visage, has against the doom, is thought sick at the act.
What act that roars so loud and thunders in the index?
Look here, upon this picture, and on this, the counterfeit presentment of two brothers. Oh, see what a grace was seated on this brow. Hyperion's curls, the front of Jove himself. A station eye like the herald Mercury, new lighted on a heaven-kissing hill. Oh, a combination and a form indeed, where every god has seemed to set his seal and make the world assurance of a man. This was your husband. Oh, look you now, what follows? Here is your husband, like a mildewed ear, blasting his wholesome brother. Have you eyes? Huh? Could you leave to feed on this fair mountain and batten on this moor? Huh? Have you eyes? You cannot call it love, for at your age, the heyday in the blood is tame, it's humble, and waits upon the judgment. What judgment would step from this to this? Sense, sure you have, or you could not have motion. But sure, that sense is apoplexed. For madness would not err, nor sense to ecstasy was ne'er so thrall, but it reserves some quantity of choice to serve in such a difference. What devil wast? That cousin you would hoodman blind. Eyes without feeling. Feeling without sight. Ears without hands or eyes. Smelling sense all. Or but a sickly part of one true sense. Could not so mope. Oh, shame! Where is thy blush? Rebellious hell. Thou canst beat it in a matron's bones to flaming youth. Let virtue be as wax and melt in her own fire. The compulsive ardor gives the charge, since froth itself as actively doth burn, and reason panders will.
Oh, Hamlet, speak no more. Thou turn'st mine eyes into my very soul, and there I see such black and grained spots as will not leave their taint.
Nay, but to live in an instinct bed, stewed in corruption, honeying and making love o'er the nasty sty.
Oh, no more, speak no more. These words like daggers enter in mine ears. No more, sweet Hamlet.
A murderer and a villain, a slave, and a 20th part the tithe of your precedent lord, a vice of kings. A cut purse of the empire and the rule, that from a shelf the precious diadem stole and put it in his pocket!
No, no more!
A king of shreds and patches! And... oh, save me, and hover o'er me with your wings, you heavenly guards! What would your gracious figure?
Alas, he is mad!
Do you not your tardy son come to chide? That, lapsed in time and passion, let's go by the important acting of your dread command. Oh, say!
Do not forget this visitation is but to whet thy almost blunted purpose. But look, amazement on thy mother sits, Oh, step between her and her fighting soul. Conceit in weakest bodies, strongest works. Speak to her, Hamlet.
How is it with you, lady?
Alas, how is it with you that you do bend your eye on vacancy and with the incorporeal air to hold discourse? Forth at your eyes, your spirits wildly peep. And as the sleeping soldiers in the alarm, your bedded hair, like life in excrement, starts up and stands on end. Oh, gentle sun, upon the heat and flame of thy distemper, sprinkle cool patience. Whereon do you look?
On him! On him! Look you, how pale he glares! His cause and form conjoined, preaching the stones that make them capable. Do not look upon me! This is the piteous action you convert, what I have to do will want true color, tears perchance for blood!
To whom do you speak this?
Do you see nothing there?
No, nothing at all, yet all that is I see.
Nor do you nothing here?
No, nothing but ourselves.
Why, look you, thou, there he goes, look how he steals away! My father in the heaven has he lived! Look, there he goes, even now, out of the portal.
Very coinage of your brain. This bodiless creation, ecstasy, is very cunning in.
Ecstasy! My pulse, as does yours, doth temperately keep time and makes as healthful music. It is not madness which I have uttered. Bring me to the test, and I the matter will reword which madness would gamble from. Mother, for love of grace, lay not that flattering unction to your soul. That not your trespass, but my madness speaks. It will but skin and film the ulcerous place, whilst all corruption, mining all within, infects unseen. Confess yourself to heaven. Repent what's past, avoid what is to come, and do not spread the compost on the weeds to make them ranker. Forgive me this, my virtue, for in the fatness of these pursy times, virtue itself of vice must pardon beg, yea, curb and woo for leave to do him good.
Oh, Hamlet, thou it's cleft mine heart in twain.
Throw away the worser part of it, and live the pure with the other half. Good night. But go not to mine uncle's bed. Assume a virtue if you have it not. Monster, custom, inhabits devil, is angel yet in this. That to the use of actions fair and good, he likewise gives a frock or livery that aptly is put on. Refrain tonight, and that shall lend a kind of easiness to the next abstinence, the next more easy, for use can almost change the stamp of nature. Either rein the devil, or throw him out with wondrous potency. Once more, good night. And your desire is to be blessed. I have blessing, beg of you. For this same Lord, I do repent. But heaven hath pleased it so to punish me with this and this with me, that I must be their scourge and minister. I will bestow him, and will answer well the cruel death which I gave him. So again, good night. I must be cruel, if only to be kind. Thus bad begins, and worse remains behind. One word more, good lady.
What shall I do?
Not this by no means that I bid you do. Let the bloat king tempt you again to bed. pinch wanton in your cheeks, call you his mouse, and let him for a pair of reachy kisses or the paddling of your neck with his damned fingers make you to ravel all this matter out. That I essentially am not in madness, but mad in craft. 'Twere good you let him know. For who this but a queen, fair, sober, wise, would from a paddock, from a bat, a jibe, such dear concernings hide? Who would do so? No. It's but a sense and secrecy. Unpeg the basket on the house's top. Let the birds fly. Let the famous ape to try conclusions. In the basket creep and break your own neck down.
Be thou assured, if words be made of breath and breath of life, I have no life to breathe what you have said to me.
I must to England, you know that.
Alack, I had forgot. 'Tis so concluded on.
There's letters sealed. And my two schoolfellows, whom I will trust as I will adders fang, they bear the mandate. They must sweep my way and marshal me to knavery. Let it work, for 'tis a sport to have the engineer hoist with his own petard. Juggle hard, but I will delve 1 yard below their minds and blow them to the moon. 'Tis most sweet when in one line two crafts directly meet. This man shall set me packing. I'll lug the guts into the neighboring room. Mother, good night. Indeed, this counselor is most still, most secret, and most grave, who was in life a foolish, prating knave. Come, sir, to draw an end towards you. Good night.